Hey guys, what's up? In today's video, I wanted to try out two Chanel things that I got. As you know, Chanel is a pricey luxury brand, but these are two items that I have just seen like rave reviews on that I wanted to try myself. One of these is the bronzer, which I have been wanting to try for years. So this brand recently came to Ulta. I have got the cream bronzer, and then I also have the sheer glow highlighting fluid. So that is what we're going to be talking about today. Both of these come in two different shades. So you've got this is the Soleil tan bronze. There is also a Soleil tan deep bronze. So this retails for $50. This is what the packaging looks like here. Super nice. I like how simple it is, but I love how big the actual pan is in here. Now there is 1 ounce of product in here, and this is the shade here. If you are interested in my base, I have got on a lot of Danessa Myricks. I will have a video coming on that, on like a full face of Danessa Myricks. But so far, I've actually been pretty impressed. All right, I'm going to take a little LaRousse brush, and I'm going to go in here. This has a slight scent, but it's nothing overpowering. It kind of smells like roses, but very, very light. So I just am going to dip in here. And as I mentioned, this retails for $50, so it's very pricey, but a lot of people, this is like their holy grail, and I'm getting more into cream products, especially as I'm getting older and my skin is getting a little bit drier. I just think it looks nice on the skin, as long as I can get something that is easy to work with, because I don't like to fuss. I do like the shade on my skin. As you can tell, it really does just look natural. And then I'm just going to put this in all the places that I would normally apply bronzer. So I always apply that to my temples. I apply it to the top of my hairline up here. And so far, this is super easy to work with because it's such a light shade as well. It's not ever looking crazy, even when I first put my brush down. Now, I will say, if you even have medium skin, I don't know if this shade would work for you. You might need to get the deeper one. Now for me, this is like perfect. I'm just applying a little bit more to my cheek area, just to make that a little bit more defined. And then I always apply some right here to the very outer edge of my face and along my jawline. And whatever is left on the brush, I'm just gonna pull down. But that was super easy to apply. It blended like seamlessly. It looks natural. It looks luminous. I have no complaints. And then I love that it's got this cover. I would keep this cover if I were you. It just keeps the product nice and like keeps the moisture in there. And I do like that this really like locks down in there. So I feel like this would last you a very long time and stay good a very long time. All right, next up is the Sheer Glow Highlighting Fluid. This again comes in two shades. I got mine in the shade Pearly Glow. There's also one that's a little bit more like bronzy taupe looking, but this is the one that I got. Here is what it looks like in the packaging. This again is 1 fluid ounce. You've got your little logo there. This is a glass bottle. Very nice packaging. This one retails for $48. Now you can use this a few different ways. You can use this as a primer. You can also probably mix this in with a foundation. Like if you have a very matte foundation, mix a little bit of this in there. It's going to thin it out and make it a little bit luminous. And then you could also use this as a highlighter, which is what I'm going to be doing. So it comes with a pump. I'm gonna pump just, ooh, very liquidy. All right, so I think I'm gonna take a dry beauty blender and I'm just going to get a little bit of this on here and I'm just going to apply this to the high points of my face. And basically this is supposed to be like a dewy, like lit from within, healthy, as the name implies, type of glow, which I have been a real fan of recently. So ooh, that looks really pretty on the nose. I will say it does look like it picked up a little bit of my foundation on my nose though. On the cheeks, I don't see where it picked up anything, but on the tip of my nose, it did take off the foundation, which I'm not a fan of. And then I'm gonna apply a little bit right to the high points of my brow. And this one, again, it's got like a slight perfumey type of a scent and it kind of smells like a rose type of perfume, but it's not strong at all and I don't smell it when I'm putting it on my face. So I don't think if you have sensitivity to smells that this is really going to bother you. It is a very light scent. All right, I'm going to go ahead and use my Fenty cream blush. This is in the shade Rose, or Rose Latte, I think is what it's called. And I'm just going to go into my little Wet n Wild brush here. And we're just going to finish out this look. Ooh, that is pigmented. So, is it worth that price tag? Honestly, I'm gonna have to keep trying it out. I do like that glow on the cheeks, but I really don't like that it picked up on my nose. I think that the glow recipe, watermelon glow, niacinamide dewdrops, I think that these do the same thing, but it doesn't take up the makeup on my nose. I have seen people rave about using that as a primer, so I'll continue to try it out. But for right now, I would say probably not, honestly. And then this cream bronzer, had I not just tried Danessa Myricks, I would probably say, I mean, that is really, really nice. It was super easy to use and I love the color. I love the shade. I love how much you're getting in here. I love the packaging of it. I love all of that. Having said that, Danessa Myricks, the one that I just tried, it does essentially the same thing and it's $26. So, having said that, it's hard for me to recommend these at such a steep price. This is MAC Modesty. Such a pretty color. And this is so comfortable going on. This is a cream sheen lipstick. But yeah, it's hard for me to recommend that at such a steep price whenever there are products that perform equally as good for literally half the price. So I'm going to continue to use these and play with these because I have them and I did spend the money on them. But I would say, honestly, save your coin. You can find products that perform very similar to this for a fraction of the price. So that is my opinion. I hope that you guys enjoyed this. I literally have been wanting to try this bronzer for years and I do love it, but you can find something for a better price that performs just as well. So hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a thumbs up, subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll catch you in my next one. Bye.